Hello viewers, please subscribe and click on the bell symbol to get more videos.
This is Mahinda Reddy. Last topic, we are discussed about magnetic effects of electric current. Based upon that, we are going to revise topics what we have covered. If we draw the mind map on magnetic effects of electric current, what topics we covered? Domestic electric circuit, we covered. What is fuse, we covered. And how magnetic field lines are formed, pattern of magnetic field lines on bar magnet, on solenoid, on straight carrying conductor, magnetic field lines. Next, field due to current carrying conductor in solenoid. And flaming left hand rule, flaming right hand rule, right hand, flaming's right hand rule, and electromagnetic induction, electric motor, how electric motor is working, and electric generator, how it converting mechanical energy into electrical energy, how it works on the basis of electromagnetic induction, Fleming's right hand rule, and how electric motor is working based upon Fleming's left hand rule. In the Fleming's right hand rule, we are putting hand in the horizontal direction, thumb finger showing motion, forefinger showing magnetic field, midfinger showing current. In the Fleming's left hand rule, we are putting hand in the vertical direction, forefinger showing magnetic field, midfinger showing current, thumb finger showing motion. These are the main topics we covered. This is the main view of total magnetic effects of electric current. After this, if we go through next paper, in that next paper, see, we had covered solenoid. Just a solenoid picture we are seeing here. Solenoid is connected to two terminals, positive and negative terminal. When we are connecting solenoid to positive and negative terminal, around this magnetic field lines are forming. Magnetic field lines are forming around the solenoid. And at the middle of the solenoid, we are observing straight lines. We are observing straight lines in the middle of the solenoid. These straight lines are parallel to each other. The straight lines are moving from south pole to north pole. Inside of the solenoid, the direction of magnetic field lines are south to north pole. Outside of the solenoid, the direction of magnetic field lines are north to south pole. This is the process we are going to observe in the solenoid. Solenoid is nothing but it is a wire is prepared in a curved shape, so many circles in the form of cylinder. Wire is prepared in a so many circles in the form of cylinder. Refer page number 10 in the PDF. We observed field lines of the magnetic field through and around a current carrying solenoid. We observed field lines of the magnetic field through and around a current carrying solenoid. This solenoid is connected to battery, plug key, rheostat. At this condition, we are going to observe field lines around this solenoid we are observing. Now coming to next point, this is the electromagnet. How electromagnet behaves? See, a strong magnetic field, produced inside a solenoid can be used to magnetize a magnetic material. Here iron nail we are fixed in between solenoid. This solenoid is connected to two battery terminals, positive and negative. When placed inside the coil, the magnet so formed is called a electromagnet. Whatever the magnet so formed is called a electromagnet. Now next to coming to point, a current carrying solenoid coil is used to magnetize steel rod inside it. Or here we are using iron nail. The iron nail attracting some paper pins. This iron nail acting like a electromagnet. Artificial electromagnets we are creating with the help of connecting battery terminals, with the help of solenoid, we are preparing electromagnet. Electromagnet is nothing but artificial magnets we are preparing with positive and negative terminal. Now next to coming to point, miniature circuit breaker. This miniature circuit breaker we are observing in our houses. This miniature circuit breaker can prevent damage to the appliances and circuit due to overloading. It is an important component of all electric circuits. Miniature circuits saving our appliances, electrical appliances in our home, saving internal electric circuit in our house from the short circuit. MCB stands for miniature circuit breaker. This kind of fuse system we are observing in apartments, in our houses. It is totally connected in parallel connection. This total short circuit is connected in parallel connection. In India, AC changes its direction for every 1/100 second. The frequency of AC is 50 hertz. Due to this alternating current, if high voltage of current enters in the houses, due to overloading of current, short circuit may happen. That we can prevent by this fuse. Next, when we are going through, if you observe the picture here, when high voltage current entering in our house, immediately if any chance is there to short circuit, automatically the fuse breaks down. Here if you observe here, this is the breakdown is happening here. Due to this breakdown, the circuit will be open. When circuit will be open, we can prevent the short circuit in our home. With the help of this, we can save the electrical appliances. We can save the internal electric circuit. With the help of fuse or with the help of MCB, miniature circuit breaker. Automatically fuse comes down. That is only picture we have seen here. And next coming to point. See, this is the fuse structure. This fuse is made with porcelain material. positive and negative terminal are there. This positive and negative terminal are connecting with very thin wire. Very, very, very thin wire. The thin wire had a high resistance. The thin wire had a high resistance. Resistance is inversely proportional to thickness of the wire. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross-section of conductor. If area of cross-section of conductor is more, then resistance is less. If area of cross-section of conductor is less, then resistance is more. Here, same point we are applying here. Area of cross-section is, area of cross-section is very less. Whatever we are using the fuse, due to this, low amount of electrons are flowing in that. When high amount of electrons are entering, immediately chances they to short circuit. Immediately circuit opens. We can stop the internal electric circuit in our house from the overloading, from the short circuit. We can save internal electric circuit. We can save the electrical appliances from the short circuit, from the overload. This is the thing we are observing from this fuses. This is the fuse, one type of structure fuse. Next, coming to, if you observe here, one end of, two ends of fuses are there. These fuses are connecting with a wire, very thin wire. These fuses are connecting with a thin wire, and after this, fuse is closing with two pins. This fuse is closing with these two pins. This, after connecting fuse, electric circuit will be made. Here we are using a very, very thin material. That material is made up of any conductor, maybe copper, maybe silver, maybe aluminium. There is a but good conductor we are using. And the wire is made with the conductor material. Next, coming to points. See, this is the electric current, electric circuit, breakage of electric circuit. First, this fuse will be destroyed. First, this fuse will be damaged. After that, the circuit opens. Passing of electric current will be stopped automatically in the extension board. With the help of this fuse, we can save the electric extension board from the short circuit. Immediately, fuse will be destroyed. That fuse we can change again with the help of another new fuse. That fuse is saving the internal circuit by the overloading of current. It prevents the damage of extension board. Now, next, coming to point. See, two ends of the fuse is connecting with very thin wire, and this fuse is inserting in this fuse, in this fork line material. After inserting this fuse in this, electric circuit will be closed, and electric circuit will be made total in the, when electric circuit will be made, electric current will be passed. This is the thing we are going to observe after connecting with fuse. Main thing you have to keep in your mind, resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section of conductor. If conductor is very thin, resistance is more. If conductor is very thick, resistance is less. This is the thing we are going to observe here. Now, coming to next pick. Now, in this electric motor,
In this electric motor, here middle is the shaft and iron core, soft iron core. This is the soft iron core, is connected with copper wire. Soft iron core is wounded with copper wire. This is only acting like a solenoid. This shaft is rotating in the middle of the it is acting like an axle, and it is armature. This soft iron core and coil we are calling as armature, and these are the ends are acting like a split rings. Even we are observing 15 HP motors, 12 HP motors, 6 HP motors. Based upon their strength, we are observing here. The strength of the motor is depend on armature. If armature is very strong, if coils are more, copper coils are more inside the electric motor, if soft iron core is more, then armature is very strong. When armature is very strong, strength of the electric motor also more. That is, we are calculating in the form of HP horsepower. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts. Armature is depend on soft core, soft iron core and coil. Even electric generators, dynamos, these also working on based upon electromagnetic induction. This electric generators converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. What is electromagnetic induction? Already we discussed the process by which a change in magnetic field in a generator, in a conductor, induces a current in the another conductor. Which a change in magnetic field. Change in magnetic field. Whatever change in magnetic field. For example, solenoid is there. This change in magnetic field with the help of the rod, we are changing magnetic field. Moving the rod inside the solenoid and removing the rod immediately. Keeping rod and removing the rod. This disturbance in magnetic field induces a current. Same kind of law we are applying in this electromagnetic induction. And flaming right hand rule also we are applying in this electric motors. In the electric generator, we are applying flaming right hand rule. Current is induced in the perpendicular direction. Current and magnetic field and direction of the force. These are all we have observed in flaming right hand rule. Just we have seen here. What is solenoid? This is the revision. What we have covered the topics in this main short questions. These are very important to CBSE board exam. A coil of many tons of insulated copper wire wrapped in the shape of cylinder is called a solenoid. Next, what is the direction of the magnetic field lines inside a bar magnet from south to north pole? Next, what is the direction of the magnetic field lines outside a bar magnet from north to south pole? These are the topics we covered. And next one is short answer type questions. What is an electromagnet? An electromagnet consists of a long coil of insulated copper wire wrapped on a soft iron core. This is the topics we covered. And the main differences between DC and AC. DC means direct current, AC means alternating current. AC changes its direction periodically. DC only follows unidirectional current. The current flows in a single direction. AC direction of current changes periodically every 1/100 seconds of India. It cannot be transmitted over a long distances. AC, it can be transmitted over a long distance without much loss of energy. Easily we are transferring with the help of electric poles. And next, source of DC is cell or battery, and source of AC is generator. Next, coming to point, the Here he is state the rule to find the direction of magnetic field produced around a straight current carrying conductor. Okay, see, in the current carrying conductor here like this in the circle shape, all iron filings are arranging in the circle shape. Based upon this we can tell it is right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule, what it is showing? Current in downward direction and magnetic field in horizontal direction. This is the we can tell this Maxwell's screw rule also. In the you can observe in the PDF Maxwell's screw rule also. When you tightening the screw is rotating in the right side direction, and the screw is slowly going inside the stick. The moment of screw shows the current direction, and the screw is moving, rotating. That rotation shows the direction of magnetic field. Now next coming to point, what is the role of fuse? We discussed fuse is a safety device which cuts off electric supply when unduly highly current flows through a circuit. Next coming to point, why does a magnetic compass needle deflect when a current carrying loop is brought near it? Okay, see, the current carrying loop behaves like a magnet and deflects the needle. First activity we observed, when current is passing, automatically deflection we are observing. This is the Oersted experiment is performed here. Next, explain the construction and working and principle applied in DC motor. Okay, flaming right hand rule we are applying in electric generators. DC is the unidirectional current, and DC cannot be transmitted over a long distances. These are the things we discussed here, and working and construction already we had discussed in the last session. Refer page number 2019 and 21 page numbers. If a generator uses direct current, it is called a DC generator. Direct current is available in batteries, cells. Next coming to point, commercial electric motors do not use a permanent magnet to rotate the armature. We are not using a permanent magnet to rotate the armature. Remaining options, if you observe, soft iron core we are using, and large number of tons of conducting wire we are observing there, but a permanent magnet to rotate the armature we are not using in the commercial motor. Maybe we can use artificial magnets also. They are observing we are in this commercial motors. The commercial motors, when we are sending electricity, it behaves like a electromagnet. Next one is the strength of the magnetic field inside a long current carrying straight solenoid is same at all points. We are straight line, similar lines we are observing. When after curves we are observing similar lines in the solenoid. This is the thing we are going to observe here. It is same at all points, that's why all are equal, parallel to each other in the solenoid. The most important safety method used for protecting home appliances from short circuit or overloading is use of fuse, use of MCBs. Next one is choose the incorrect statement. Fleming's right hand rule is simple rule to know the direction of induced current, and right hand thumb rule is used to find the direction of magnetic field due to current carrying conductor. Right hand thumb rule, direction of magnetic field, very good. Difference between the direction direct and alternating current is that the direct current always flow in one direction, whereas the alternating current reverses periodically. These are all we discussed. Fleming right hand rule, induced current, Fleming right hand rule we discussed. How current is inducing? Fleming right hand rule showing, first it is showing, we are putting in hand, putting we are in horizontal direction, right hand. Thumb finger showing direction of force or motion. First finger showing direction of magnetic field. Mid finger showing direction of induced current. This is the thing we are going to observe here. Now, here, incorrect statement in the fourth option is, in India, AC changes direction of after every 1 by 100 second, not 1 by 50 seconds. Assertion and reasoning. No two magnetic field lines will intersect. It is true. Magnetic field lines are not going to intersect each other. These are each and every magnetic field lines have individual path. Next, magnetic field lines do not have a specific direction. It's wrong. Each and every magnetic field lines have a specific direction and individual path. Now, the magnetic field inside a solenoid is uniform. Yeah, yes, it's correct. Straight lines are forming in the middle and at the ends, making a curved shape lines. Next, the magnetic field lines inside a solenoid are parallel. Yeah, yes, it's correct. All lines are parallel. Here, see, if you observe here, your iron filings after sprinkling on the solenoid, that iron filings are shuffling like this. Here around circles are framing in the middle, straight lines are framing in the middle. These are parallel to each other. Now here in the rotated circle shape wire, at the ends circles are framed here, and straight lines are forming in the middle. We are observing in the circular wire. The circular wire is arranging on the cardboard. In the picture, it is arranged on the transparent cardboard or transparent plate. After sprinkling iron filings, we are observing this effect. Next, coming to point. According to first activity, here compass needle is moving according to first activity. Compass needle is showing the direction of magnetic field. At the ends of the magnetic field, strength is more. At the middle, strength is very less. Or at the midpoint of the magnet, the strength of the magnet in the midpoint of the magnet, it's zero. Now next, coming to point. Here if you observe, the strength of the magnet is more at the poles. That's why more number of iron filings we can observe here. Very less number of iron filings we can observe here in the middle. South and North pole, if you observe, iron filings are showing the group of iron filings, how arranged here, you can observe here. These are the iron filings, pictures of iron filings, how arranged here. Pictures of iron filings, how structure we are observing, magnetic field structure. Okay, these are the pictures. At the ends of the magnet, the strength of the magnet present more at the ends of the magnet. Poles are showing more force comparing with the middle of the magnet. Most of the force is present at the ends of the poles of the magnet only. Now next, coming to point. Here horseshoe magnet had more strength at the ends. That's why more number of iron filings are present at the ends. Whatever multiple choice questions will come. The direction of magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying current can be determined by right hand thumb rule. Already we discussed. Down finger shows the current, curled finger shows the direction of magnetic field. Next, magnetic field lines produced by the flow of current in a straight line is a phenomenon discovered by Ayerstedt in 1820. One separate paragraph is there. Right hand thumb rule is explained by Ayerstedt. Next one is the magnetic field produced due to a circular wire at its center is, just now we discussed, it is perpendicular to the plane of the wire. It is in clock rotation. The magnetic field exerts no force. A stationary electric charge can't exert no force. Magnetic field can't exert any kind of force in the stationary electric charge. Next, at the center of the magnetism is zero. You have to remember this thing. At the middle of the strength is more at the ends, and middle is zero. The strength is zero in the middle. Which of the following instrument works by electromagnetic induction? Dynamo is working. Dynamo is generating current. That dynamo is working based upon electromagnetic induction. A DC generator is based on the principle of electromagnetic induction. DC generator is based on the principle of electromagnetic induction. The use of fuses in electric power lines is, the use of fuses to open the line permanently. If I overload of current, if it is generating, then automatically open the line permanently, then we can prevent the damage of electric circuit. Next, when the main switch of the house circuit is put off, it disconnects the live and neutral wire. Live means positive wire, neutral means negative wire. Main switch, when we are switching off main fuse, automatically it disconnects. For making a strong electromagnet, the material of the core should be soft iron core compulsory, and more number of coils should be there. The soft iron core plus coil we are calling as armature. Next one is, the soft iron bar is introduced inside a current carrying solenoid. The magnetic field line inside the solenoid will be increased if due to soft iron bar, due to more number of coils, the magnetic field will be increased. Next, the magnetic field lines inside a current carrying solenoid are along the axis and parallel to each other. We discussed all lines are parallel in the solenoid. Next, in our home we are using 220 volts AC current we are using, that is frequency is 50 hertz. In the next one, potential difference between live wire and neutral wire is 220 volts. Already you know, we in our home we are using 220 volts wire. Potential difference we are observing. A device for producing electric current is generator. Electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. We discussed electric generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The ring system of wiring is better than the tree system because it is less expensive. Ring system of wiring is better. It is very less expensive. Next one. Four students plotted the sketch of the pattern of magnetic field lines representing the magnet field around a current carrying straight wire ABCD. Which one is current? He is asking. Is the fourth one is current? Fourth one is correct. Here positive terminal, negative terminal is here applied. Here it is moving from negative to positive, and here resistor is prepared. Here resistor connected, plug key connected, batteries connected. The direction of current also is showing. Okay, which one of the following sketch is correct is D. Next one, a soft iron bar is enclosed by a coil is insulated copper wire. When the plug of the key is closed, the face B of the iron bar marked as North Pole. The place B, he is asking the face B, it is North Pole, it is South Pole. See, in the lines are moving from South to North Pole. Choose the incorrect statement from the regarding magnetic lines of field. Magnetic field lines are parallel, equidistant, they present zero field strength, individual path. We are studied pattern of magnetic field lines in bar magnet, in current state current carrying conductor, in a solenoid. Now next one, commercial electric motors do not use a permanent magnet to rotate the armature. Permanent magnet we are not using to rotate the armature. That is only option, correct option. Power is transmitted from powerhouse and high voltage and alternating current is. It is more economical due to the less power loss. It is very useful to us, very advantageous to us. Very low amount of energy is losing by AC. Very low amount of energy. Now next, coming to point, a positively charged particle move in circular path with uniform speed. And next, magnetic field exerts a force if the charged particle moving across the magnetic field lines. Okay. Now, an electric charge is uniform motion produces in both electric and magnetic fields. Next, in a safety use, electric charge uniform motion both electric and magnetic field. Just we all referred and we put your doubts in comment section. Next one is, in a safety device, the temperature of which wire gets heated does not depend upon none of the use, this radius of the wire, type of alloy used. Must see high temperature melting point is present to tungsten material only. That's why tungsten using in bulbs, the melting point of the tungsten is 3320 degrees Celsius. Next one is, the current flows in a conductor from east to west. The direction of magnetic field at a point above conductor is towards north side, south pole to north pole. It is moving in the inside the magnet. Next one, induced current flows through a coil only for the period during which flux changes through it. When flux is changing, automatically it is moving. Flux, magnetic flux is changing, this magnetic flux only changing. At this condition it is moving. Induced current flows through a coil only for the period where there is a change in the magnetic flux. Till change in the magnetic flux, then only current is inducing. Next, when a fuse is rated at 8 amperes, it means it will burn if current exceeds 8k. If more than current is entering more than 8 amperes, then fuse will be burned. That's why the capacity of the fuse is shown as 8 amperes. Next one, a 2.5 meter long straight wire having a mass of 500 grams, it is suspended in a mid-air by uniform horizontal magnetic field. Then after doing this, M is equal to 500 grams, G is equal to 0.5 kg. And I is equal to 4 amperes. 500 grams we are converting into MK system and I is equal to 4 amperes. F is equal to ILB sin theta. F is nothing but MG. ILB sin 90 degrees. If you observe this, if you complete this, refer this, work out these problems and put your doubts in the comment section and after forward to me. Next, it is only for 40 minutes class. In the 40 minutes we have to recover, we have to revise all topics. Next, the circular loop is suspended in air as shown in figure. When the loop is seen from the above, current flows in anti-clockwise, and seen from the below, current flows clockwise. The loop behaves as a magnet. The north pole of this magnet is on the upper face. On the upper face, north pole of the magnet is there on upper face or lower face. It is moving in anti-clockwise direction. The arrow mark is present in the anti-clockwise direction. This is the clockwise direction. This is the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, that's why it is moving from year to year. That's why it is north pole is there upside upward direction. North pole is there upward direction. Now a student connects a coil of wire with a sensitive galvanometer as shown in figure. He will observe the deflection in the galvanometer if bar magnet is moved towards or away from the coil parallel to the axis of the coil. Connecting coil of wire with a sensitive galvanometer. Okay, very good. Now he will observe the deflection in the galvanometer if bar magnet is moved towards or away from the coil. Galvanometer. When bar magnet is moving towards away from the coil, then we can observe the deflections in the compass. Then we can observe the deflection in the compass. Now, electric supply is how this here. P is equal to VI. I had done the problem here. Refer this problem. I is equal to P. P power is equal to voltage into current. Then current is equal to power by voltage. Here power given 2200 volts. 2000 watts power given, 100 watts bulb given, and 220 volts. After, if you substitute 2200 volts by 220 volts, you can complete this problem. Next, 37, F is equal to mu naught by 2 pi I1 I2 by DL. These are all you can observe. When magnetic field is depend on distance between B magnetic field is proportional to I by R. In the first we discussed magnetic field is depend on distance between the magnet and magnetic objects, and magnetic field is proportional to current. Magnetic field is inversely proportional to distance. Last class we observed this. Okay, shall we wind up now the class? Thank you.
Hello viewers, please subscribe and click on the bell symbol to get more videos.